Trauma has a way of silencing us. We feel ashamed of what has happened to us. I would have never have guessed that I would be here like this. Like, I knew I was strong, and a part of me always felt like there has to be more, but I didn't know how far it would take me. I didn't know that the abuse and trauma that I went through would lead me to a place of like freedom, that I would ever be freed of it. So many voices have been silent, and they need to speak out and say, this was done to me and it's not right, because there's help. There's help, there's healing, there's freedom. And we fight back by giving one another permission to feel, but also giving ourselves permission to feel. By saying, you know, we stand united in fighting this fight against child abuse trauma, against our own trauma. We can live in spite of what happened to us. We could thrive and not just survive, but actually be free of the chains that hold on to us because of the things that happened to us. That wasn't our fault. So my purpose is to shout it to the rooftop that you're worth it, that there's so much more that you can have out of life. There's a fight out there. Maybe they don't see all the time, but there's a fight. You know, children in their home and stuff. And these children are gonna be our leaders. This is gonna be our population. I love the pinwheels. I love the visual statement of don't forget. And I love the pinwheels and how they, the wind moves them. Cause I feel like in the same sense, it's like us being the force, you know, behind that to move the system, to make it better. And I think it's also so strength to fight for yourself, to actually be able to speak up and say, this happened to me. And I just say, keep fighting the good fight. The battlefield can be tough, but I promise you're not alone. I stand with you on the battlefield, and we can do this, and we can teach others how to heal as well.